I hope everyone is able to see me. Well, good afternoon. Today is Wednesday and this is Sex Talk with Sharonda. So I hope y'all can hear me. I hope y'all can see me. If you can hear me and see me, please let me know that you can hear me and that you can see me. And that way we can get started. So I just need y'all to like put some little heart marks or just say, yes, I can hear you. I can see you. It's good on this end. That way we can get started with this live this morning. Well, this afternoon rather, because it's lunchtime. So today, I'm going to be talking about walking on the wild side. A lot of people are like, well, what you mean, Sharonda? What's the wild side? Like, where you going with this today? So I just want to make sure that y'all are able to see some of my little props that I have. I'm going to slide back some so that you can see my props. Okay. And forgive me, but I forgot my iPad at home, so I'm unable to actually see the questions, but I will make sure that I answer everybody's questions. And if you want to shop online for any of these products that I'm about to talk about, you can go to www.theppgstore.com. And if you like what I got on, of course you can come and purchase this bad boy at the PPG store. They come in all sizes, plus sizes. A lot of times women don't really understand. When I tell you that we sell plus size lingerie, we go up to a 4X. So we started small. So the latest is petite. I don't want you seeing stuff and being like, oh, Sharonda only carry for plus size. It's just that when I presented to the plus size lady, because I'm a plus size lady. So I presented to the plus size ladies, letting them know that this is available for you too, okay? So just in case, let me stand up a little bit so you can see. You see this? This is what it looks like. So it's an all-into-one titty, okay? So make sure. All right. There we go. So we're going to get started. I'm so excited about today's topic, walking on the wild side, because so often people just have traditional sex. So this week I started talking about spitting during sex, and some people were actually turned on and a lot of people were turned off. And I'm just one of those people, like, I don't like to overthink sex. Like, I just kind of like to go with the flow and create experiences and memories that we both gonna look back on and be like, we did that shit, you know? So, of course, I have my cattail whip, and if you never used one before, you can slow it down. So just imagine, I just want you to imagine, a motherfucker got you bent over doggy style, and he ain't even got the dick in you, and he taking all of these little tassels, and he rubbing them up against your asshole and your pussy, and just playing with you, teasing your body. Got you all bent over and you gotta just surrender yourself, and he taking it, he tickling the pussy with the whip. This is a cattail whip. If you never saw what this, if you didn't know what this is a cattail whip. And as you can see, y'all, I'm real excited about this, because when I leave and I go to classes, this is the kind of stuff that I like to get knowledge about, because this is the kind of stuff that I enjoy. This is like taking sex to a whole nother level, you know. But you got the cattail whip, and if you look, it's just like a little sting, but if you needed to harder, you could do that too, okay? This type of stuff should not be intimidating when somebody comes to the bedroom with something like this. And ladies, let me say this here. If you're trying to be a mistress for the night, meaning you're trying to dominate a man for the night, because that's the title, she's a mistress or a madam, you gotta come to the bedroom looking the part, okay? You can't come to the bedroom and nobody's gonna take you serious. Like, you gotta have your outfit on and everything, honey, okay? You gotta look the part, okay? So this is the cattail whip. So of course you gotta have your props when you come to the bedroom. Then we have the paddle. Now, what's the difference between the paddle and a hand? Both of them are used for spanking. The only difference is one is a prop and one is a part of your body. He can hit you with the same force with his hand as he can with a paddle. Stop letting this stuff scare you and intimidate you. Do something different. Try something new. And when he's spanking that ass, bitch, let me tell you what you're supposed to be wearing. You need to have on a pair of these crotchless panties with the pearl hanging from it. Now, I'm going to tell you about these panties here. One, the pussy is out in the open. He gonna be able to get to it, okay? But you got these pearls. Now you can take these pearls and you can actually put them inside of you and let him get them out with his teeth. Or you can take the pearls and just let them hang out. And as he's thrusting in and out, these pearls are stroking his shaft all at the same time that he's thrusting in and out the pussy. Okay? So, of course, these are for my regular size ladies. But hey, I'm a big woman. So, plus size ladies, I got you. I got these for you too, honey. So, you could get these crotchless panties with the pearls here at the PPG store. I ordered a whole lot of them for underwear day. But the order came in late. Underwear, National Underwear Day was August the 5th. And the order came in like August the 7th because everything was delayed for whatever reason. But I got all of these beautiful panties up in here that, baby, look, you ain't got to do nothing but come to the bed with nothing but this on. And he going to be like, what? Oh, yeah. So, moving on. Let's talk about getting, you know, real kinky. This scares people. See, when I get to pulling this out, this scare people. And I'd be like, what you scared of? You see my finger? I want to make sure y'all can see me doing this. You see me sticking my finger in here? You see that? You see that? Why? Why am I able to do that? Because this is soy wax, okay? This is different than your Family Dollar candle, your Walmart candle, your Circle E candle. You don't want to use those candles for what I'm about to show you, okay? So what you want to do is you want to take this candle and you just want to take it and you want to just drizzle it all over your titties. Just drizzle it all over your titties. And you want to take it and you want to rub it all in, right? All sexual and sexy and sensual and stuff. Preferably when you're riding a dick because you want to make sure you mount it, okay? You want to make sure you in place, mount it. And you on that dick and you taking a candle and you dripping it all over your body, right? And you taking it and you rubbing it in. Because see, what he don't know is this is a flavored candle. And you going to take and you going to feed them strawberry titties to him, okay? And the titties going to taste like strawberries. Okay, bitch? Oh, I know. He wasn't ready. You wasn't ready. Wasn't nobody ready. But see, everybody see candles and think hot wax is going to burn. This candle does not burn the skin. It don't burn the skin because it's soy wax, okay? You should be able to get about, I'm going to say about 10 to 15 uses out of this candle. And when you finish with it, blow it out, put it up to the next time, okay? So that's what, when you're playing with hot wax, that's what that is, okay? A lot of times people see it on porn and you be thinking people being tortured. They ain't being tortured like that because it don't burn the skin, all right? Another thing, I was kind of debating on if I was going to pull this out. But because, you know, I love collars and chains and whips and all of the above, sometimes, you know, you just got to do something a little different. You know, let him walk you around the house or you walk him around the house with your collar on. Mm-hmm. Just want to make sure. Because see, a lot of times y'all come in and it's all of this stuff that y'all pass up. Y'all pass all of the stuff up. Coco! Girl, these bundles, oh shit. They getting caught up. So ladies, with your bundles, make sure you put your bundles up before you get to hooking up your collar. Alright, there we go. So I got my collar. Fix my hair back because you want it to look sexy, ladies. And this is a unisex collar. I actually got some other collars. They're a little thinner. They're not as thick. But this is a unisex one, so men and women can both use it. So now he can walk you around the house. And you can be his little sex slave, his little bitch, his little whatever he want to call you and whatever you want to be called. You can be that, okay? Or vice versa. You can put it on him and you can walk him around. Okay, now when you go to Vegas, you actually see people out in public with this shit, with the collars and all of that kind of stuff on. It get real serious, okay? It get real serious. Then we have the mask with the mouth part open. That way, you can cover his face or cover her face, and the mouth is still available to you. Again, this video is about walking on the wild side. This is not your traditional sex, okay? This is not the average, this is not what you normally would do, okay? And the last thing that I'm gonna talk about, oh, I have one more thing, the nipple clamps. But then we have the fisting gel. Now, I'm not into being fisted. I've never had nobody to take their whole fist and put it up in my pussy. Never, ever had that happen. I love my lady too much for that. Like, I'm not gonna let you do that to her. I'm not gonna let you mistreat her like that. But for the people who actually want to experience fisting, this is a fisting cream, and they put it all over their hand, and what it does is it numbs you vaginally or anally so that they can actually put their fist inside of you. So I'm just trying to let you know that even though some products I don't use or I've never experienced, it does not mean that it's not available to you, because it is available to you, okay? And my favorites, the nipple clamp. Now, if you look at these nipple clamps, you see this black on the end. These are called buffers. That way that they don't pinch your actual nipple too hard, but it allows the grips for the nipples to be able to, for it to hold on to the nipples. So all you wanna do is turn this at the bottom, and as you're turning it, you're gonna see, I wanna make sure you can see it. You see they opening up, and you adjust it on the nipple, then you turn it and close it back to make it pinch the nipple. Okay, so basically, again, this is a great for when you're riding. You put these on the nipples, right? And while you're riding, he can actually take and tug and pull on them, okay? Really, really great form of stimulation. Really, really great form of stimulation. So, ladies, my birthday is next week. And my birthday party is next week here at the store. And we are having an indoor-outdoor rodeo. And I'm having the mechanical bull. So if you have not gotten your tickets to my Dukes and Books rodeo for my 38th birthday party, because that's when I'm turning 38, you're going to miss out. Because you already know when I throw a party, you know it's going down. You know, I'm actually downsizing this year, but I don't even really feel bad about downsizing it, because normally I'm always looking for big venues and big this, that, the other. But because I'm doing indoor, outdoor, like, baby, we about to have a rodeo, bitch. It's going to be a rodeo. The drinks is going to be flowing. If you ever came to anything that I have done, you already know that I don't have step, okay? So the tickets are only $20, okay? Normally, the tickets for my birthday party be $45, $50, and up. Of course, entertainment going to be on deck. We got the mechanical bull. It's just going to be a good time, baby, because if you know anything about me, I'm not going to have it no other way, okay? So, if you have not gotten your ticket, you need to get your ticket. Go online to www.theppgstore.com and get your ticket to my Dukes and Boots Rodeo August 24th. We saddling up at 9 p.m. sharp. 9 p.m. sharp. We saddling up. Make sure you wear your Dukes and Boots, because I love pictures. So, if you know me, I want pictures with everybody. And, bitches, I want your booty cheeks hanging out. I want to see some ass that night, okay? I want it hanging out a little bit. Now, if your man acting crazy or whatever, put your little pair of distress shorts on and you just bring your ass on. I understand. But for the rest of y'all who free like me, bitch, I want to see y'all. I want to see your ass hanging out. We wearing Dukes and Boots. And I got to find me a cute cowgirl head. So, you know. But go online, get your tickets. That concludes Sex Talk with Sharonda. I love y'all. Have a wonderful Wednesday. Happy birthday, Madison. My baby turned 10 years old today. Happy birthday, Madison. And guess what? Tomorrow, I got to go and take my other daughter. She's going to college. So we got to go and get her set up tomorrow. I'm excited. I'm having a wonderful week. So y'all have a wonderful week, too. And if you have not booked your party with me, you need to book your party, because I'm the motherfucking host that does the most. So if you ain't never experienced a party with me, you need to make that happen. You need to book it. That concludes my show today. Thank you.